little different than all the rest. I'm quite old-fashioned, wear a hat, sometimes play chess. And when I'm out, I'm looking for that vintage fling.
Hello, beautiful women. This is Eloquently Emmy, and welcome back to my channel. And welcome to Fashion Moment 14. Yes, and I have that one right too. So anyway, what we're going to talk about today is if you have a lovely blouse like the one I'm wearing from End Other Stories. This is a lovely linen blouse. And of course, here in South Carolina, again, it's 80 degrees still. So typically I have a pair of actually this color linen shorts that I would wear it with, do something really monochromatic with my espadrilles, my nude espadrilles, or I also have a pair of very high-waisted, natural-looking jeans, and I have some almost like Riviera capris in the natural look, again, going monochromatic. It's so easy to dress this up. I suppose I could even, I have some light pink jeans that I could put with this. So there's so many things that I could do. But the question is, how can we transition this outfit for the fall and make it work? Okay, so basically that's what we're gonna talk about in this video. And, but before we do, let me take a couple steps closer to the camera and I'll talk to you a little bit about the Saint makeup that I'm wearing today. Okay, so the last makeup video I did, I used number 33. I kept calling it Emerald City. It's not. It's a lovely, lovely shade of green. Now I want to try the Emerald City. My curiosity is piqued. But yeah, let's just talk about the eyes briefly and a new color that I'm wearing. So anyway, basically what I did is I went in with my MAC primer. I went in with my vanilla dust to create a better blending base. Then I actually went into the number 33 and bought it right up in here. Okay, but before I did that, wait, I want to talk to you. I forgot about my contouring of my eyes. That's what I call it. And I've been using Lullaby for the longest time. I was on a little bend and snap kick, but there is a new color called Eve, and oh, I just adore it. I just adore it, and especially for this purpose. It really works well on me and has just enough purple to really make me happy. So that's what I did. I contoured my eyes so that I had less of a hood. So actually I went in the crease, I went down here on a little angle, and then I kept my eyes straight open and contoured with the Eve up here to create depth in my eyes. And it definitely, if you have hooded eyes or you just want to have some more depth, I love this color for that. Let me just shut my eyes so you can kind of see. Okay, so then I went in with the number 33 because I'm again looking at my blouse, being an artist, and I'm looking at the colors, and it's a linen, and it's we've got greens and purples and and pinks, and that's where I was headed. So anyway, so I did the 33, and then I did Chwanda, and then I did a little bit As If, okay? And then I mimicked those three colors again, right here, on right into my lashes, and a little bit of color under my eyes. So it, you can almost see here, the 33, and then the As If, okay? And then I used my Marc Jacobs eyeliner, the gel eyeliner that stays on through thick and thin, and I used it in the Plum Age. I guess, I don't know. I don't know how you pronounce it, but I'm going with that. And then I used the color Obey on the inside here, which is a pinky, kind of a light pinkness. And I actually brought it down in here a little bit too, just to make my eyes sparkle a little more. And of course I used my L'Oreal Ultimate waterproof mascara as usual, and I use Kohl on my eyebrows, and then I went in with a little I mixed Sabrina and I mixed Sis right here in this area and this area. just to get that pop in my eyes and to get the dodging and burning effect that I like so much. And basically, I don't know if I said it, but I basically tightlined in here so that you don't really see a line here, just a little more depth. Okay, and then the highlights I used, I had a little issue, so I touched up that issue. I'm not gonna tell you where it is. That's the whole point. Anyway, with some mango, and then I went in with Sandy. Okay, yeah, kind of a really light natural coverage. And then I went in to highlight with a candlelight here and here and here. And then I went into super highlight with the new color Versailles. It's our new highlight. And I did a little bit here, working on that Rembrandt triangle look down my nose and on my chin. Okay, and I contoured with Ash. And as far as lip and cheek go for my cheeks, I used Plum, Summer Love, and a little bit Angel at the top to get that lit from within glow that I love. And then on my lips, I used the Black Cherry and Dahlia with a little Angel to make my lips pop forth more, and I line them with the Smashbox Deep Mauve Liner, okay? And that just, I overline my lips. It's just something that I do, and it really helps. It really helps at my age, 55. As I've told you before, haven't had any procedures yet, not against them, but it works. So something to consider. Okay, so, hey, if you would like to get started with the Saint makeup, I would love to be your artist. So basically all you have to do is click the link below in the description, and it says want a color match? And you click that, and I will send you a color match survey with just some basic questions, what kind of coverage you like, whether it's light or heavier coverage, or a mix of both depending on the day, whether you want your face and your neck to match, whether you want your face to be lighter, what colors you like, etc., etc. Just gives me an idea about what colors will work on you and a little bit about your skin type and what you like. Okay, so basically too, in there is instructions to send me a window light selfie. Okay, no makeup, no filters, it's just like the one up here. And I will take a look at that, and I will send you back your beautiful color match with all the colors that are perfect for your beautiful, unique skin tone. Okay, it will have all the products listed, the pictures, the colors. It will have a face map to show you where to apply the colors, and it will have written instructions. And I do always check back with my customers, and I send them videos. And of course, I've made so many videos, but what could be any easier than that? So I know you're gonna love this makeup. It just the qualities of it, the longevity, the ease of application, how compact it is when you travel and just at home, having everything in one place, not having a big draw of junk where you can't find anything. And I love what it does for my skin, how it keeps the hydration in, and it just does so much. I mean, I'm 55 years old, and this is what my skin looks like with this makeup. And if you watch my videos, you'll see what it looks like without. So what more can I say? I couldn't sell it to you anymore. I love it. I want to share it with you. Okay, so and I will be here as your artist to help you all the time, and you can always contact me at eloquentlyemmy.com, and I will help you out, and I will be there for you as your artist. Okay, so now let's just start talking about our fashion moment. Okay, ladies, so let's just talk about what I'm wearing right now, and then I'll talk to you about how I'm gonna transition it into fall. Okay, and we'll start from the bottom to the top. That's how I usually do it. And yeah, so let's just go with that. Okay, so I am wearing these really, really cute Talbots slingbacks. They're woven, they're metallic, they have little gold bows on them. They're so sweet. And again, if I was wearing this, if I wasn't transitioning for the fall, I'd be wearing it with my linen shorts or my high-waisted linen pants for like a monochromatic look, as I said. But I just adore these shoes. I adore the heel on the back. That is really important. It just gives them just an awesome look, and it just elevates the shoe and it elevates you. And the pointy toe, of course, makes you look taller. But they're flats, so you can like walk around in them all day. They are so comfortable. This basket weave is extremely comfortable. So that's what I'll say about my shoes. So next, I'm actually wearing a pair of olive green chinos from Land's End. And they're 100% cotton, and I just like them. They're kind of, I don't know what they call them, classic waist. They're almost high-waisted, but not. So we're almost following the rule of thirds, but I don't know, we're on the fence. But this top, this top is a very crop top. If you had a long torso and you didn't want to show it, you would have to really get some high-waisted pants. Did I need to wear this belt with this? Probably not, but I like how it looks, so I did. And this is one of these cute little Amazon belts that I purchased in a set, and I will list them below. And so then, I love this top. I just adore this top. It's from And Other Stories. And this is another company I love. And this is pure linen, so it's so breathable. I'll just get a little closer, but you will see in the fashioning what it looks like. But I want to show you some of the details of it. Okay, I love the puff sleeves, and I love the square neckline. It's so pretty. It actually, when you put it on, you zip it right here, and that's how you wear it. And then I'm just going to turn around a little bit so you can see the back, the smocking on the back. And yeah, I can't see, but you can see it. Anyway, it's so cute, and it's just made so well. And I really like where it sits, being petite. I love where it sits on me, and I love the beautiful pattern in it. It's just so light and airy and nice, but you can still wear this into the fall. You know, there's different parts of fall, and this is early fall. And again, like I said, I'm in South Carolina. I could be wearing shorts, you know, all through October. But I know a lot of you aren't, so I am going to talk to you about how to take this outfit that I started to transition and really transition it into the fall weather. Okay, so next you're going to see me wearing my Gianna Beanie booties, ankle boots. They're croc and they're absolutely gorgeous. They give me a lot of height. They're well made. They're specially made. This designer especially works with Dillard's, so that's where you will find her and all her boots. And boy, does she have quite the selection of boots. I was looking this year. She's got a lot of bling going on, which is really interesting. Might be really cool for the holidays. So of course I love the boots. And so next, you will see me wearing it with my Loft pink jean jacket, which is a crop jacket, and it's really lovely, and I like where it cuts off, and it just gives you that extra little layer of casual warmth, and I like that a lot. And I think it's just really sweet looking. It goes so well with this. And so, you know, you've got a little bit of fanciness, a little bit of casualness with the, you know, straight cotton khaki material, the denim and the linen, all these natural fabrics. And I really like that look. Okay, so then if you really wanted to take it up a notch, I would wear, I have a blush blazer from Loft. So you'll see me wear it with the blush blazer, and I think that looks really lovely too. You could always change out the pants for jeans. Jeans go with everything, of course. You know, or if you really want to wear a heavier, I have a heavier kind of high-waisted white jean, and I have enough chutzpah to pull that off. So that's another route that you can take to transition into the fall. And then if we're gonna go great guns, we might as well put on our Calvin Klein pink trench. And I love this trench. It's to die for, it's gorgeous, it's pink. And yeah, you might think that, you know, you could do this in the spring and everything, but you can do it in the fall. I mean, I think with the, I love how pink and green go together. And of course, think of the color wheel and everything. But I really like the natural fibers, and but then having the more elevated boots and then the trench. And I just really like the way that looks. So we're talking layers. We're talking layers, ladies, to keep ourselves warm, but to be able to wear these tops, you know, into the early fall. And I really like doing it that way. And I really like the whole look. And yeah, so before I finish off, let me talk a little bit about accessories. What have I got on today? I'm wearing, of course, my mother's gold ring, my platinum wedding band, my mixed gold bracelet, pulsar watch, and I'm wearing these little petite hoops that are in gold, and I like wearing them. And I'm wearing my Mirabella Busy Bee necklace. I just love this necklace. It's just so sweet. And I think it went really well with this outfit. And I also, I wore it with two different purses. Of course, I wore it with my Brahmin Moonstone, and then I wore it with my Brahmin Mini Quinn in, gosh, I can't remember what the name of the color was. I don't know that they have it anymore, but so you gotta, when you see something you like and it's a little different, grab it. But it's a beautiful, pink blush color with a gold metallic running through it. And I just love that bag. So yeah, I think that went together just perfectly. So yeah, mention in the comments, which bag do you like better with this outfit? Okay, ladies, and yeah, I did just wanna try this outfit on too with these long pants from Loft. I love the high waist silhouette that it gives me. And I know it's a natural color, it's not a white. And I know people are freaked out about wearing white and stuff like that after Labor Day, but it's just totally fine. You just have to have the chutzpah to wear it and not worry about what anybody else thinks or anything. But this could definitely take you, you know, through early fall, it could take you into spring. And I love the silhouette that the pants give, the long lean silhouette the pants give me. And it's almost a monochromatic effect, I would say, with the top of the, you know, my top and my pants being very similar in color. And then my shoes, my pointed boots, giving me that really elongated look that, you know, is very desirable if you're petite or if you just want to look taller. So yeah, and don't get stuck on, you know, I don't wear oranges. You won't catch me in orange, mustard, a few other colors like that, because I don't look good in them. So why wear colors that you don't look good in just because it's fall and those are the colors of the leaves and everything? If those colors don't look good on you, don't wear them. Okay, so that's something really important to remember. Wear the colors that work well with your coloring and your complexion. So, you know, I've got the pinks and the greens going on in here, and you know, the little bit of purple, and that's what looks good on me because I'm cooler. I'm even pushing it a little bit with this cream. I'd probably do better with a bright white, but you know, you don't have to follow all the rules exactly. But again, like I said, you would not see me in orange. And one other thing that I wanted to mention too is with this accessory, the Mirabella, I love this. And I just wanted to show you how it is adjustable, which was very helpful for this shirt. So you can see that it's got a little ball right there. And this can be 24 inches, or it can almost be, as I'm wearing it today, choker style. And then it flips to two different designs, and I'm really not sure what I've got going on there now. But I did have a face, and now it's something. Anyway, but it's a really cool necklace because of the adjustability and everything. So yeah, I wanted to tell you about that. And of course, you know, if you are cold, you can totally rock the pink Calvin Klein trench coat with this and you would be fine. This feels very substantial to me, you know, the linen and the cotton, and yeah, especially for the South Carolina weather. So yeah, that's what I wanted to talk to you about as far as these pants. And I wanted to show you with these pants as well, because I thought it looked really, it went really well together. And yeah, I wanted to share it with you. Hey, so yeah, I hope you enjoyed that Fashion Moment 14. And I hope it gave you some ideas about petite styling and how to take some beautiful blouses that you have through the spring and the summer and transition them into the early fall and really pull it off. And yes, if you like content like this, don't forget to click like and subscribe and hit the bell for notifications. Okay, and yes, I want to thank you for your time and always remember to live your life passionately.
A little different than all the rest. I'm quite old-fashioned, wear a hat, sometimes play chess. And when I'm